How to solve the third equation? We'll start with an example. So if I have, say, 5, now this is third root of x to the power 4, and this is given as 405. How do we do that? Simply, we know that this is nothing but this third root means raised to the power 1 by 3. So this is x to the power 4 and raised to the power 1 by 3. What is 4 into 1 by 3? This is going to be 4 by 3. So I can write this as 4 by 3. This will be 5 x raised to the power 4 by 3 equal to 405. Now I am left with 5, so I will divide both sides by 5. So this is x to the power 4 by 3. Why? Because 5 gets cancelled. And then we have 405 by 5, which is going to be what? 81. 5 into 81 is 405. Now, if you see, I can write this 4 by 3, this 81 is what? 81 can be written as, 81 is 3 2s are 6, 3 7s are 21, 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9. So 3 to the power 4 it is. So it is x to the power 4 to the power 1 by 3 is equal to, this 81 can be written as 3 to the power 4, like this, right? So 1 by 3, can I get something here to make them equal? Yes, I do. How? This is x to the power 4, 1 by 3. If I put 1 by 3 here, what I have to do? I have to divide this by 3 or multiply by 3, sorry. Because I need to cancel it out. If it is x to the power, see, this is nothing but x to the power 4 by 3. And this is simply 3 to the power 4. I need a 3 here. I need a 3 here to equate them. So if I need a 3 here, I have to take it to the power 3. I hope you got the idea. That is, this is x to the power 4 by 3, and this is 3 to the power 4. So if I can get some 3 here, I can equate them. But for that, if I put 3 here, I have to take it, raise it to the power 3 also. Right? So now what I can do, I can bring this down and I can take this up. X to the power 4 by 3 is equal to 3 to the power 3, 4 by 3. I am taking this up and 4 here. I can always do that. 3 into 4 by 3 is 4 by 3 into 3, like this. 4 by 3 I took above and 3 I brought here. So if I say some value a to the power x is equal to b to the power x, that means a and b has to be equal. So here x and x 3 to the power 3 is equal because the power raised are same. This will be x equal to 3 to the power 3, that is x will be equal to 3 is 9 and 3 is 27. X will be equal to 27. This is how we solve it. We'll take one more example. Okay, you can always check this, but I'll take one more example. This example is x, or you can take say z minus 4 root z plus 3. We're just taking it z because any variable you can take, x, y, z, anything you can take, equal to 0. Now this is what? This is z minus, and this is what? 4 z root is, can be written as z to the power half, and this is plus 3. How do we get it? If you see that I can write this as z to the power half minus 3 into z to the power half minus 1. That is root z minus 3 and root z minus 1. How? Root z is z. This is minus root z. This is minus 3 root z. And this is minus 3 and minus 1 is plus 3. So z minus, this is what? Minus root z and minus 3 root z is minus 4 root z. Plus 3 equal to 0. So this and this are equal. So I can write this as this one. So I can write this as z to the power half minus 3 into z to the power half minus 1. This is equal to 0. So when two values are 0, that is x into y equal to 0, that means either x has to be 0 or y has to be 0, or both are 0. So I will write this as 0. Z to the power half equal to 3. That is root z equal to 3, that means. So z will be what? If this is half, when it goes, it will be square. That is z will be 3 square That means I am taking, if I take square, square, both sides, this gets cancelled and this will be z square. So, z will be equal to 9. Let us take this one, z to the power half minus 1 equal to 0, that will be 1. Take square both sides, this gets cancelled, z will be equal to 1 square 1. So, 1, 1 and 9, these are the solution. Okay, 1 and 9. So, this is how 1 has come, this is how 9 has come. So, you can just verify also, you can put the z as 9 here and z as 1 here. Now, we have one more example, that is, we have to solve for p. Under root p minus 2 minus 3 equal to 0. So, what we will do is, let me show you. We will take this term here, root term here and other terms here. That is, the root or cube root, anything which is there, we will keep it on the one side and the other on the right hand side. That is, we will write this as root p minus 2 and I will take 3 here. So, when 3 goes here, it will change the sign. Now, I will square both the sides. Why? Because I know this is 2 only. So, squaring it will cancel the root. That is, p minus 2 to the power half and I am squaring it. That is, 2 gets cancelled with 2. So, p minus 2 will remain. This is what? 3 square. That is 9. Now, I am taking 2 here. P equal to 9 plus 2. P will be equal to 11. This is what? You can check also. If you put p equal to 11, you are going to get 0 only.